start with a quick look at the operations report. Oh, there's more spotting reports, more spotting reports. See, even in the operations report, we don't have any reports when we actually arrive at a destination. So when your units arrive at a base, you either have to check it or remember it, or if you forget, it could sit there for a long time. The fortifications have increased, that's good. Reinforcements arrive. Quick look at the intelligence report with hotkey I. See that we've actually shot down as many, or we've destroyed as almost as many air of the enemy aircraft as we've lost. Score is about right, but looking at the ships sunk, we had a really good day near Vigan with the PT boats, but the enemy got revenge near Miri. Looking at China, notice in the north, we'll start with the north, and this Chinese unit has been under bombardment. I've been watching it. Watch the experience has actually been going up. So as long as we are under attack, our experience goes up. So I thank the AI for bombarding me gently and training me at the same time. The enemy's moved out of Pao Tao, so I'm going to order my unit to recombine and move south, east. We'll divide again. We're still recovering more strength as we move forward. In Cheng, this is the big combat in Chengchao. There was a huge battle, but we also increased our fortifications. So we now move from a 1 to a 2. We have, looking at the base, we have about 358. I think we lost almost 200, almost 100 assault value there. It was a bloody, bloody battle. Let's see, it was under the combat. That was the loss of Hong Kong. This is the bombardment attack. Here we go, Chengchao. That's a lot of casualties to the Japanese. They've been hurt, disabled a lot, but we actually took 29 destroyed outright. So we took the brunt of that one. It's the 35th Division attacking us. I think what's happened, see, notice all the little fragments of units. I think we took losses because we were broken up. Where we were not broken up, but yes, it separated into smaller units. Now that we're in actual combat, we'll have to recombine, and this usually means a tougher unit. But the problem was, I didn't think the enemy would be on top of us so quickly. What happened was he crossed the river and initiated a shock attack. I thought he'd be coming from down the road where his other unit had moved in, but he crossed directly from Kaifeng. We can see this by the ownership of the hex. See that it's a red line here. He crossed through that hex. I had units coming up from this way and they arrived just in time, so they probably bore the brunt of the attack because they were in a movement mode when the enemy was in a combat mode. So even though the units in the base might have been in combat, I think they were in combat. I could be wrong. They could have been in rest mode. They were in combat because they were building the base. So even though they were in combat mode, they were broken down, and the enemy had a shock attack. So taking a look at the reinforcements, we only have about 350 or so in here. That's quite dangerous. But we have a reinforcing corps coming from this side. Examining them, they're just two or three away. So they're almost on top of us. At this point, we don't want to take any risk. So I'm going to order them to move in under combat conditions. By moving under combat load, they should be able to move two hexes. Two, or this one would be three. So I think they should be able to cover that last little one hex. That last little, they're just at the edge of the hex. Now, I don't want to recombine them yet, because if I recombine them, I'll lose all the Oh, I can't. Well, okay, I can't. Because they're, oh yes, one's at 43 and one's at 45. So yeah, that's why I can't combine, recombine. I was thinking about moving some of these, this core southward. They're moving to the southeast. So I will order them to move. Oh, well, it's just started to move. So we still have plenty of time. This is a core that has moved in from behind, so we still have plenty of time to get to the edge of the hex, and then I'll advance one hex into the combat. We've also got more reinforcements. No, not here. We've got another core coming in from the side. This one's also heading for Chengchao, but we've got plenty of time, plenty of reinforcements coming, another few hundred easily. So I could probably bring, that's 200. This one would make another 200 or so. So we'll probably have easily 1,000 in here before too long. I think we can hold it. Checking through, we've had to recombine a number of units at Changsha, Kukong, all through. Just, there's no way to, nothing to do except each and every hex, one at a time. What a pain. In the north, this unit was headed toward Yinan, and we're going to reset it for signing. Because signing has a garrison requirement. We don't know how, oh, and this is 70, should fulfill it nicely, freeing up the extra 200. The loss of Hong Kong really hurts. I did not learn my lesson with Wake. I could have pulled the aircraft out earlier, but I did not. So I'm going to try to learn the lesson at Nanning. Instead of having it all broken up, we'll suffer the slower reconstitution rate. But at least we'll be together. Hopefully we can defend a little bit more strongly. Various components are arriving at their bases in Burma, so I'm just bringing them out and putting them into combat mode, or resting them in Tonggi, awaiting the enemy onslaught. There wasn't any much combat around here, so we're in, well, it's a slight lull in the battle. The enemy hasn't attacked us at Chumpon either, but he's advancing down the road. Looks like he's going to take Victoria Point behind us. Nicely done. One ship has arrived and is unloading, docking to unload before heading back. We may as well take a full reload, refuel now, because we're in Rangoon, where there's still a refinery. With the amount of, well, we can, it's only 29,000, is not a lot of oil, not a lot of fuel. Here comes another with another 1,000 points of supply. Because it's such a, oh, it's so difficult to unload. What's left here? Ah, one, I hope it'll still unload. Sometimes the base is too small and it won't allow us to unload the, and it won't tell you why, because it's a zero base right now. It may not allow us. We'll see. We'll see. We may have to go to a bigger base, unload it, and then send it back up here, which is kind of silly, but that's the way the game works. It doesn't warn you what the unload rate, why you cannot unload it. It just won't unload. I think the little AKLs, so anything under 1,000 points is probably going to, I think it'll be okay sneaking in, but the larger Mundra and Chilka were too large, so I won't even put they were 2,900, 6,400. That's a pretty big ship. Okay, so we made our escape. Now we're going to head for Cape Town, Abadan. More convoys, or I don't know, the blockade runners, maybe we call them. I'm using the larger ships. We're going to try to drop supplies into Akyab The smaller ships are still going to head towards Calcutta. No, pardon me, to Rangoon. Now that we're at Akyab, we're going to order our supply here to stockpile so that the enemy. Oh, let's try it. I don't think it'll pull this far simply because of the bad roads. Chittagong is going to do the same. It's going to increase demand so that we can try to run a couple of the small freighters. We're also going to stockpile so that it doesn't backflow. Units are arriving at the front, or at the confrontation planned confrontation line, and we're putting them in to start construction. More reinforcements have shown up at Aden, so we'll form them into another transport group. We'll load the Hussars. Great. Set home base for Karachi. Making sure we do not steal the fuel. Looks like we were successfully in grabbing the last of the Adu. Now it's just Diego Garcia for the pickup. Transports are finished loading. We're sending them to Aden. I keep forgetting about Aden, and I say send too many to Abadan. I think I will practice sending the transports to the personnel transports to Aden because it still is a good trickle of supplies coming from there and the occasional units. Whereas Abadan, I don't think we'll have many units appearing. So we'll send the transports to Aden and the, or sorry, the personnel transports to Aden and the transports to Abadan. The units that are okay, they're still in strategic mode. Units leaving Bum. The Gurkhas are down. We're just waiting. Where are the rest of them? Oh, the Gurkhas are in two different pl are already moving towards Imphal. We'll meet you there. The Japanese have not made a move in the Malay Peninsula, allowing my troops to get off the train and go unload. Most of the Dutch subs have expended approximately 50% of their torpedoes, but it's still too early for them to return to base. This sub has. Oh, wow! She's shot everything! Been damaged too! Great shooting! An excellent patrol. We'll recover in Singapore. Resupply and repair. One sub has already made it back. We will send her into dry dock. Notice how, look at all that damage. 15% damage, and she repairs it in one day. Oops. Not the Prince of Wales. The tiny little sub, 670 tons worth. There were a number of battles fought out here. Let's find it where we were intercepted. Right here, 6484. Right by Miri, is this 6484. So there's an enemy task group out here harassing my shipping as we try to flee. So I'm going to form up some cruisers and try to rescue the rest of my ships. Another task force is set, transport group is set to unload 30,000 more tons of fuel or points in Singapore. This is kind of an odd thing. This transport group was heading south and somehow it got, well, okay. Thank goodness I caught it, or else they would have sailed all the way for Aden. We'll detach the cruisers. We'll set to meet the cruiser task force here and merge. Maybe we can exact some revenge. Time to evacuate Palembang, but with the presence of submarines in the area, we make sure we send them off with an escort of destroyers. As stated earlier, I think this unit arrived here, it's been here for a while, but we just haven't realized it because there's no warning, so you just have to be checking on these all the time. Okay, where is Bengalis? Oh, okay. Since we can't move any further on strategic, we'll change to movement mode and march for Palembang. In Palembang, we have just one of those things. The engineer, this is part of the Merak base force, right? And if you check the pieces of it, it's the northern part, except all the other parts are in the south. So, well, that's the way they designed it. We'll have to go retrieve the other three pieces of this. But we also bring the rest of them out of, or now that they've arrived, we'll either rest them or put them into combat. Okay, we're trying to pull out this last base unit, and it's leaving one engineer vehicle, one bulldozer behind. Now, the base is a size 2 base. We're on amphibious. I just don't know if we have enough. So, it says we're loading. I think we should have loaded it by now. So, I'm just going to cancel the load and head for Kuching. The reason why it's going to bother me, but I figure the enemy will do us the favor of destroying this bulldozer for us. Oops, we'll put it in the most vulnerable, so when the enemy arrives, it will destroy it very quickly, and we'll try to pick up a few more. Unfortunately, there's an enemy destroyer cruiser group around here. We've still got a destroyer and an aviation support tender, or destroyer-wise. So this one, we'll try to meet and merge with this one for a little protection, so we don't get, at least we have some protection. These two little AKLs, yeah, we'll do the same. It'll slow them down, but we've already lost a whole bunch of these little freighters. This ship is out of fuel. So we're heading in to grab some fuel and then head out. These are retreating from a surface threat. Okay, we will join them. We'll head for Singapore. Maybe lead the enemy into our cruisers. Full mission speed. In order for them to move, I think we'll have to order them to just totally ignore all the threats. Otherwise, they could be running around forever. This one's also trying to retreat from a surface threat. So if he's moving this way, that means that there's the threat's out here. Okay. We will order him to meet and merge with this group. There are other ships out here. Oh boy. The little gunboat cannot stand up to a cruiser or even a destroyer. These are, okay, these are the ships that were fleeing from Hong Kong. They're carrying the fragments. Oh boy. To come so far and be killed, I guess we'll just form a big task force here. In the Philippines, my PT boats have fired all their ordnance and we're coming back for torpedoes. Unfortunately, we can't get torpedoes because the base is too small. I took the tens out because I didn't think the PT boats would survive. So what we're just going to do, disband the PT boats. We'll return them to the pool, live to fight another day. This PT boat up here is damaged. I'll also return it. I don't know if it comes back repaired or comes out damaged. I just don't know. The two destroyers have been repaired, or one destroyer has been repaired. We're waiting for the other one. This Thracian is still, it probably won't take her long to repair, but she's just limping back into port. Okay, the enemy has entered the hex, so we better rebuild the unit, prepare for combat. We're trying to evacuate the rest of the planes here, but they're damaged, so they're being repaired very slowly. But we can't leave until all the planes are repaired. So every time it moves, we cancel it and order another move. We've arrived in Bayombong. We'll rebuild the unit, go to combat mode. We have engineers, so we'll try to dig some trenches, or shallow graves as they call them. The destroyer will be done in one day. We'll go to high priority. Even though there's only one ship, high priority, I find, my gut just, I think it works better. Okay, the ships that were running for their lives managed to get out of the harbor without loss. That's pretty amazing. I accidentally hit the coastal button on this one, so it was trying to follow the coast. Now that we're clear, we can set back for normal. I've got two submarines patrolling out here looking for that carrier. We'll change back to regular speed now that we've cleared the enemy task force. Hopefully we can survive. We're surrounded on all sides. We just don't know where to run. Okay, now I'll retask the submarines to go attack this beachhead, just like we're doing over in Malaya. The submarines have had a field day near, where is it? Heng Chung. So I don't see why I would bother sailing further for a patrol. The enemy seems to be sending his amphibious ships through here, so I'm going to congregate my submarines in this area. I'm going to reposition these, now that Hong Kong has fallen, to also cover this strait. That seems to be where all the action is. The surviving PT boats from Hong Kong are going to run for Quangchawan in order to drop back to disembark or disband so that we can throw them back into the pool for another day. A submarine was trying to blockade this passage, but now if there's going to be a cruiser up here, we'll sail right in there after him. He can still come out and try to block the passage. Unfortunately, with these little blue markers, you never know which one's the first, the second, and the third. Too bad. I wish they'd just maybe change the color so that we don't have to be guessing when we're changing, when we're assigning them. The Penguin has actually escaped all the way from Guam and made her way southward. Great. I can't believe I screwed up again. The same screw up as before. I am moving troops instead of picking them up. What a doofus I am. All right. Troop. I guess we can't pick up from this location. All right. Pick up the company of New Guinea rifles. Got to keep track of the troops on the south, on the west coast. Now that the Australian battalion has arrived, we put them on the train. They came in out of the bush. Can we get all the way to Townsville? Yes. Same as the fragment fragment here. A long train ride. The base force is rescued from Kangaroo Island, and the little ships, well, will rebase over in Brisbane. The little French detachment noted that, oh, the ships are burning! This was probably not going to make it, so what we're going to do is we're going to break them up, let them make Rarotonga at their own best speed. They'll probably have to just sit there and put out the fires. And pump water. Now this one doesn't need to make Rarotonga because she'll just head straight for Noumea, as she's already loaded. We'll use a waypoint to keep her from running across Suva, where that suspected submarine is operating. We'll head out here in a nice deep ocean. The units at Pago Pago are still loading. Looks like the most important one is the United States Naval Base. And this one, look at all that motorized transport that's just going to be wasted sitting here. I bet you it won't load. The cruisers are heading towards Tulagi. The carrier groups have returned to Pearl Harbor, even though there are three submarines detected around it. They'll pick up their carrier groups. I think VB2 is for the, yes, Air Group 2 is Lexington. We fly them on because if you fly them on, there's less damage to them. If you just load them, they have to be repaired, and I'd rather just have the flexibility. Oops, not that one. Okay, that's it. Air Group 6 is, oops, not transfer base, transfer to the Enterprise. Torpedo bombers for Enterprise VT-6. More Dauntlesses, Scout Bombing 6. And no fighters. Now we'll disband the groups, the ships into the base. They can do a little bit of repair. What's the surface combat? Oh yes, these are the minesweeping group, also disband into the base. We will now transfer the remaining buffalo. See, these were already damaged, so these will go aboard, transfer to a ship. Lexington. So they appear damaged. They are winched aboard by a crane. We'll prepare to embark all these, not all of them, the anti-aircraft artillery we can do without, but all the other engineer units I'm going to take to the South Pacific. I think I'm going to leave this aviation battalion behind. It's going to be one busy little unit as the engineers try to build up either Midway or probably Midway and then Johnson Island. We evacuate the base force from Lahaina. Check in the dry dock. We see that there's room for more ships, but we're going to order the New Orleans to repair with the tenders, with the ships, because they don't need the shipyard. It's too big to fit. There's too many ships already in there. Let's see if Raleigh will fit in the shipyard. Yes, Raleigh will fit in the shipyard, so we'll send her in. Detroit will not. See, that's too big. Well, we'll send Raleigh to a... There we can repair them all in about 3 weeks. An empty tanker is inbound for Pearl. If we want her to survive, we better send out some escorts. In these... Oh, which ones shall we send out? The least damage will leave the other ones a chance to repair their damage. Well, we don't need that many. Bring her home. Reinforcements arrive in the Panama Canal. We order them to join the current task forces to load and head for Pearl. Looks like some of the fuel has transferred across. That's good. But the other side is now run out. Oh, man. When it rains, it pours. So we have 1,200 here, and we'll need 4,800. This one has 11,000. We'll pretty much need all of it. When it rains, it pours. The ships have finished loading at San Diego, so we'll group them all together into one big group transfer right now, while we load the other ships. They'll just keep themselves full up by refueling from the port and won't get in the way with the other ships. Many reinforcements also arrive in San Francisco. We immediately set the tankers to start loading fuel. I form a task force of all the amphibious capable ships. These are the dedicated assault ships, not the XAKs. XAKs are just, well, they don't have the additional, I guess, ability to land over the beach. So we'll verify the load. 58%, 100% cargo space. Okay, we'll accept it. Also, this is for Tulagi. These, hopefully, these will get, I'll be able to unload everything quickly there. If I'm going to also create another transportation task force with just supplies. Take these big ones. Wow, pretty small ships. Okay. If these ships cannot unload quickly enough at Tulagi, I can always send them, the rest of them, over to either Noumea or Australia. I'm not using these other transports here. I'm saving them in reserve. These are the non-amphibious capable transports. I'm saving them for moving troops back and forth from safe locations. Another transport capable of conversion for AKE has appeared, and we will convert it. There it is, Ruth Alec, AKE, looking back in 12 days. The remaining transports that have just arrived from Seattle will form up, will load with supplies to replenish Pearl Harbor. Pearl Harbor, they actually don't need so much replenishment, but they need transports. There aren't any ships down there, or very, very few. They're all small ships. All these are restricted to the West Coast, so there's no point in sending them over to Pearl Harbor. And I don't want to spend any more victory political points buying them, especially since I need some coming out of Australia. This tanker from Portland's been sitting here for a little while, all full, refusing to go. Okay, I guess we have to send her out manually. A lot of the groups gathered from Canada. Where shall we send them? Oh, for now we'll send them down. Oh, what's the largest air base? That just needs a little bit more work. They're all pretty small. We'll send them over to Portland to help in the construction. The ships are approaching Dutch Harbor for evacuation. Got to make sure we turn off the full refuel, or else we'll suck the base dry. Even though we're trying to evacuate the base, I'm trying to leave the fuel there so that we're going to have to buy out this sucker. We'll leave it at an Air Force base. Try to leave the supplies and fuel there in case we might need in an emergency as a ship passes by. We'll now do a check for the aircraft, hitting the A under patrol. Let's see if there's any reinforcements we may have missed. Nope, looks like we've got them all. Almost forgot, at Pearl Harbor, with the air threat from the carriers gone, we'll order the units back to full power training, all the level bombers. Anti-submarine attack on the Malaysian coast. The submarine persists. Japanese subs attack, but unsuccessful. Oh, damn it. The Japanese surface group intercepts another merchant as she tries to escape. Thracian hit by a torpedo. Her luck finally ran out. Another merchant caught and murdered. Is this by the same group? No, looks like it's a different group. This is heavy cruisers. The light cruiser group finds another small freighter. Chengdu goes under. The Dutch Avenger. Another kill from the Dutch. Yet another one. S-38 increases the tally. The Japanese light cruiser force gets another. The Dutch sub tries and is sunk in the attack. Well, nice going. Sea Lion attacks at Legazpi and is hit in return. Swordfish fires. Sea Lion fires. Permit gets a hit. Air attack on Taiping. The Buffaloes are overwhelmed. Second attack. B-17s hunt transports at Legazpi. Air attack, Alor Star. The Buffaloes fight hard. Air attack, Wuchao, near Canton. Air attack, Kukong. Kwe Sui bombarded. Free experience for my troops. San Fernando under shock attack. The Philippine division holds.